I'm back with another video. I don't know where these songs that are not songs come from, but good morning, afternoon, good night, beautiful people. How are you? How are you? How are you? How are you? How are y'all doing? I'm good. Thanks for asking. Welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time, welcome. Today's a great day to have a great day. In case you didn't know, I hope you're ready for a vibe, because I got one for you, okay?
Let me catch your vibe. Let's just take our time. Just relax your mind.
Today, I want to get into this really, really good topic because I struggle hard with this. I'm hoping this AC turn off real quick, okay? But just want to say, please make sure that you smash that subscribe button. It would really help me grow. And at the end of this video, please share this video, because I would really, really appreciate your support. Now let's get into this topic, all right? Let's go. Oh, sorry, I was having my drink. In your spirit. This is what I have going on for myself. This is mine's yours. This is mine's. Would y'all ever have like a little something in your cup, but you have it neat, so you just throw like some fruit in there? Cause I feel like chaser is extra calories. So it's like, why would we put extra calories in the liquor? Cause the liquor, if it was liquor, I'm just saying, it's like, cause it already is like full of sugar. So why not just put like natural fruit? It don't really help with the kick, but if it feels healthier inside, if you're drinking alcohol, it's not really healthy, but yeah, you get what I'm saying. But y'all ever, yeah, am I the only one that does this where I take like, my in-laws gave me a fresh mango, a good mango from their tree. So I know it's filled with love in that mango. So I cut a piece of it and I chopped up the pieces and I put it in my cup. Y'all like that? Yeah. That's good. When I hopefully finish this cup, the mango is gonna have been sitting in that, so it's gonna taste delicious. But that's not why we're here. Let's get into this conversation real quick. Okay, y'all ready? So today we're talking about forgiveness. Now I know y'all know I preach like typically the same narratives: forgiveness, self-love, self-care, that type of vibe, empowerment, some jokes, and all of that. But what I'm saying is, how long are we supposed to like hold things against people? Because I know, depending on what it is, like somebody rape you, they violate you, of course it's like there's no such thing. Well, some people still find a way to forgive, which is very dope. But what I'm saying is, like, when people make mistakes, because I think there's a difference between somebody just being a bad person and somebody making a mistake. So I wrote this, I'm gonna read it to y'all and then we're gonna talk about it. Okay, so this says, people make mistakes, so how long do we wait to forgive? I'm saying this says, like, I didn't write it, but people make mistakes, so how long do we wait to forgive them? Or do they deserve to pay for that mistake forever, depending on what it is? Should people be constantly reminded of their failures? For example, Chris Brown. And I'm only using that example because that's something everybody's pretty familiar with. Like, Chris Brown made some mistakes. Now, some people think he's a good man. I personally don't know him, so I don't really have much in to think in that regard. But I will say that social media, per what we see, shows that he's a pretty dope father. And it seems like he's a pretty dope person. Like, outside of the issue with Rihanna, which is hard because I'm a domestic violence survivor, to just be like, oh, let that go. But if Rihanna forgave him, so we're going to take it out of celebrity. Now bring it to your personal life. Some people have made mistakes. Like, for me personally, I am good at holding some grudges. And not even holding grudges, but it's like, I just cut somebody off. If I feel like really, really hurt and tried, I just got to go. And then I'm just gone. And then bye, that's it. Like, I'm not coming back because I'm hurt and I'm traumatized. So I just, like, that's just how I move. So it's hard for me to forgive sometimes. It's even to forgive myself, but what I'm saying, because it's like I judge or scrutinize myself for some of the decisions that I've made. But I just want to know, when it comes to forgiveness, how does it work for you all? Because for me, I've learned and grown to believe that if you say that you forgive someone, you should truly, sorry, I was looking at something. But if you say that you forgive someone, you should truly forgive them. Because if you say that you've forgiven someone and you keep making them pay for that mistake, or you keep holding it against them, is that real forgiveness? And I'm including myself in this topic because I have definitely told my man in the past, it's okay. And then waited like a year and been like, but remember that one time? And it's like, I had to look into myself to be like, well, damn, I told him I forgave him, so why? And it wasn't like cheating or anything, but it's just like, if I say I forgive you for something you forgot, or you didn't show up to something that I really needed you at, or whatever, am I supposed to hold it against you if I say I let it go? So for me personally, I just believe that if you're gonna say that you forgive someone, just do it. And if you can't forgive them, then stop accepting apologies and saying that you forgive someone, because you're wasting not just your time, but their time. I think that everybody makes mistakes. I think it's very easy, especially when you're on social media. This cancel culture will have people feeling like gods, boy. Boy, I tell you, somebody say, they slip up and say the wrong word or the wrong thing one time, y'all come out like it's judgment day. Like y'all, some people come out real strong just with so much to say about everybody's decisions and mistakes. Like, y'all so perfect. You feel me? And I find that real insane. Like, truly, that's real, real crazy to me how, like, we are so quick to forget our own flaws, that all we do is judge each other and judge others and try to tell people where they messed up at, like we never messed up before. I believe in forgiveness now that I've grown. It's taken me a long time, but I believe that, especially if you love someone, this thing is, it's acting up. Okay, hey. But just, especially if you love someone, if you say you forgive them, do it, because life is short. And if you want to, in your heart of hearts, forgive them, even if you got to talk to somebody, go to therapy, get mediation, whatever the case may be. And it could be for any reason. Somebody that you love, that you trusted, could have betrayed your trust. They could have told somebody something private of yours. None of these things are okay, but I'm saying, if you put in your heart of hearts and you choose to forgive somebody, then you should really do that. But if you can't, then you don't, you know? I just don't believe in, like, saying that you forgive someone and continuously bringing them down for the same mistake that you said that you forgive them for. I think that there's no time period on forgiveness. I believe that, honestly, some people, it's real easy for them to heal. Like, I was like, what's happening? This, boy, I'm looking at some riots. It's crazy. But I'm telling y'all, like, I don't think that it makes sense to continue to put the both of y'all through something just because you yourself can't get it together. If you need time to forgive someone, take your time. Step back, fall back. Even if you have to stop talking to somebody but you love them, take that time. But don't let something on your heart that really is not that serious, that won't matter in 5 years, hold you from continuing to cultivate or build certain relationships. And if you say you're gonna do something, you should genuinely do it. I'm learning that too. So like I said, I'm not out here just giving unsolicited advice that I'm not taking. But constantly reminding people of their mistakes and continuously telling them they owe you so wrong for this, you so wrong for that. Nobody wants to hear that. Maybe they need to, but maybe it's not your place. So it's a lot of things. But y'all let me know what you think in the comments. When it comes to people, celebrities, friends, family, whatever the case may be, how does it work with you when it comes to forgiving them? Is it easy for you? Is it something that, like, you really hold grudges, so I'm gonna throw it back in your face and you gotta take that if you want me to forgive you in the end? How does it work for you? I told you how it worked for me, so drop down a comment below and let me know. Also, please make sure that you share this video, because I just would love to grow my channel and my brand. So the more shares I get on all my videos, the better. I would really appreciate that. And subscribe if you haven't. Anyways, I'm sending y'all so much love, light, all things good. And I'm sending y'all the spirit of forgiveness today, because everybody in their lives has been through something that's left them feeling resentful. I feel like it's blurry. I don't know why. There we go. Is it? There we go. That's left them feeling resentful. I hope it wasn't blurry for too long, but left them feeling hurt, left them feeling like angry. But it's like, you got to let that go for yourself and for those that you are around, you know, or just let them go. But do something, but don't just hold that inside you, okay? That's just my word. It's just advice. Take it or leave it. I love you anyways. But I'm sending y'all all the good things, okay? So stay safe. Peace. My name is Probie. I ain't say it this time, but y'all know my name. It's Probie. Peace.